Homicide detectives have released CCTV footage of a vehicle of interest in the investigation of a fatal shooting of a man in Sydney's southwest. About 2:40 a.m. on Sunday the 10th of January 2021, emergency services were called to a William Street, Fairfield, following reports that a man had been shot. Despite the efforts of police and emergency services, they were unable to revive the man and he died at the scene. He has since been identified as 34-year-old Amar Kettule. Following initial inquiries by officers attached to Fairfield Police Area Command, the matter was referred to the New South Wales State Crime Command's Homicide Squad, who commenced an investigation under Strike Force Fitzhill. As part of the ongoing inquiries, detectives have released footage of a car that was seen near William Street at the time of the shooting. The vehicle describes a dark-coloured Jeep Cherokee and was discovered burnt out in Smithfield later on that night on the 10th of January 2021. Police are urging anyone who has any information to contact Crime Stoppers on 1-800-333-000. Happy to take questions.
So obviously you're of the view that the people inside this car of interest were the ones that killed Mr. Kettule?
We believe the vehicle may be linked to the shooting and obviously to the murder.
Where did this car come from in the first place?
It was stolen a couple of days prior to the shooting in the Fairfield area.
Okay. And what are its known movements after the shooting?
That's why we're appealing to the public. Anyone who may have seen anyone linked with that vehicle, either before the shooting or after the shooting, urged to contact police.
Were there any other known sightings of that vehicle beyond obviously where it was burnt out and where it was initially seen at the shooting?
That's what we're trying to work out. We're trying to get a timeline of where the vehicle might have been sighted before the shooting on the 10th of January or after the shooting. It's really important we get that timeline and get that information. Every bit of information would help us, and it may help us link who may have been in the vehicle.
And have you got any suspects so far in this shooting?
At the moment, we're appealing to the public for anyone who has information who might be able to identify who was responsible for the shooting.
How many people do you think were involved in this killing?
Look, it was more than one. Obviously, there's people who would have assisted prior to the shooting, who were involved in the shooting, and after the shooting. So there's more than one person involved. There's more than one person who would have helped them before or after. And we believe there's people out there who would know who these people are.
Do you think that there were multiple vehicles involved in pulling off this shooting and that maybe they switched cars after being...
Look, that is part of the investigation. We're still trying to confirm that. And that's why today's appeal is important, to try to establish who is linked to this vehicle. And that may lead us to other vehicles that may have been used.
You mentioned there were probably multiple people involved in pulling this off. Is there a lot of planning that goes into an organised crime murder like this?
Well, this is obviously a well-planned murder. The victim was taken by surprise and let's say, virtually assassinated in his vehicle.
And is it your understanding that he had actually arranged to meet his killers and then was unaware he was going to be ambushed in such a way?
No, we believe he was caught unaware. I think it's a point where we're still trying to establish what happened, what the movements of both Amar and is important as well, but the circumstances are still under investigation. That's what we're trying to find out, and trying to go through numerous inquiries, trying to link his movements as well.
What can you tell us about Amar and his sort of underworld connections, if you like?
Look, again, it's one of the lines of inquiries. Ongoing conflict is between criminal groups or criminal networks or factions. That's one of the line of inquiries we're looking at. His involvement in any criminal activity is obviously a line of inquiry. Looking at associates, looking at people that may have wanted to have contact with him and harm him, that's obviously and have conflict with him, that's another line of inquiry. It's a continuing look at both what his movements are and what he's been up to in his activity, but other people.
Is it fair to say that he had more than a few enemies in this world?
It's fair to say that we're still trying to establish the motive of why he would have been killed, but we can't discount there would have been people that would he would have been coming in conflict with.
Do you know why he left his house at 2:30 in the morning?
We're still trying to find out the timeline and why he would have left. There was a number of those inquiries are still ongoing. It's painstaking work that the detectives are doing at the moment. And there's a large number of inquiries and a large number of people that we're speaking with.
And there's also some ballistic testing that I understand is being carried out at the moment. What can you just talk us through that process and what it sort of looks at?
Yeah, part of the inquiries obviously is the forensic testing and also the ballistic testing. That's still ongoing. Trying to link this shooting to other shootings is another line of inquiry. And that's an obvious line of inquiry that we're trying to do.
And so far, has that shown up any sort of leads? Have you been able to link it to any other shootings?
That's ongoing with the ballistic testing and also with the forensic testing, that's still ongoing. We're hoping that may give us a lead, but we're still forensically testing both the crime scene and the evidence we have at the moment.
And what sort of weapon do you believe was used? What sort of calibre gun do you think was used to kill Mr.
I'm not going to go and elaborate on the calibre of the weapon, but there was multiple shots fired. The intention was quite clear. It was to murder Amar, and so by having multiple shots, they achieved what they set out to do, and that was to assassinate him.
Do you think that his murder could have anything to do or any links to the shooting of Simeon Marcus months earlier?
We're still looking at those links. They're part of the ongoing inquiries that we're undertaking. The conflicts between different factions of criminal networks. And I think it's a point where there's some conflict that, you know, we're trying to make sure that doesn't escalate. I think the community's had enough of shootings. We've had enough of the violence. People don't want to keep on waking up and seeing the blood of on the streets that have stained the streets from young men who have lost their lives as a result of a shooting or a murder. And I think it's important that that's why we're appealing for the community to come forward with information, because they've had enough. We want to work together to get the results. We don't want it to escalate into more violence. And I think the easiest way is they give us information, we can help put the people responsible for the murders and the shootings and put them in a cell where they belong.
Given the type of people that are involved and street gangs and whatnot, has it been difficult for police to try and get that information about exactly what was happening in
Kettule's
life before he died?
Yeah, it's always the type of people that we're talking through in the investigation, and we are talking as part of the investigations is the criminal activities of people, maybe associates or people in conflict. It's always difficult to look at, get information from that type of criminal network. I think it's important that we can continue to try to do that. I think the community expect that those who are responsible for any shooting or any murder should be locked up, and that's why really it's really a strong appeal for those people who actually do know what's happened, who have information, who may have been involved either before, during or after, to come forward, because we don't want this to escalate into further violence. And we want to put these people before the court and put them in a cell for a long time.